Today briefly, we'll be speaking on the topic, comfort under affliction. Comfort under affliction. Then you can put dash, tears of relief. Praise the Lord. Comfort under affliction. Tears of relief. And our text is taken from the book of Psalms 56, 8 to 11. Psalm 56, 8 to 11. And it says, Thou tellest my wanderings. Put thou my tears into thy bottle. Are they not in thy book? Verse 9, please. When I cry unto thee, then shall my enemies turn back. Your enemies will turn back in Jesus' name.
Amen.
This I know, for God is for me. In God will I praise his word. In the Lord will I praise his word. In God have I put my trust. I will not be afraid. What man can do unto me? Praise the Lord. When the first time I read this scripture, I got so excited. Why? I discovered that every tears I shed is not wasted. The psalmist said that God will put your tears in a bottle in heaven. God takes cognizance of all the afflictions of his people, and he does not cast out from his care and love those whom men have cast out from their acquaintance. God is afflicted in our affliction. And I pray, God will comfort you according to the time wherein you are being afflicted. And he will give to those that reap in joy, who sow in tears, in the mighty name of Jesus. Everybody has cried some time or the other in their life. There are some of us that have cried inside of us. Nobody can see it. In our secret places, in our closet, in dark areas of our life, we've shed tears. Nobody sees it. Why there are some that have cried openly and people have seen their tears? And I know that whatever tears that we have shed to the Almighty God, that God will answer you speedily in the mighty name of Jesus. I was discussing with a friend of mine one time, I said that I know how to cry very well. That if I was to be featured in Nollywood in the crying aspect, I would do very, very well. And I said, so many times I've been hurt, but I go in the secret and I cry to God. When I come out strong. I want to make you to understand that there's a mystery concerning tears. And as the Lord is going to open our eyes, we'll have understanding in the name of Jesus Christ. The Lord Jesus wept publicly at the funeral of Lazarus. In John chapter 11, verse 35, the Bible says that Jesus wept. So if Jesus could weep, when we are weeping, we should understand that God is attentive to our cry. The Bible says that when he wept, others were saying that he loved Lazarus, Elias, his friend. But after the weeping, the next thing he did was to give thanks to God and pray, and Lazarus came back to life. He also prayed with tears. Are you here that you have prayed in tears before? It is not strange. In Hebrews chapter 5, verse 7, the Bible says that who in the days of his flesh, when he had offered up prayers and supplication with strong crying and tears unto him, that was able to save him from death, and he was what? Hard in that he feared. He cried in tears to his father, and the Bible says he was hard. Your tears is not in vain. What did I say? Your tears is not in vain. Thankfully, those tears have always drawn me closer to God. That is my story. In university, I gave myself a slogan that God should help me, I don't want to offend people. God should help me not to hurt people. Anytime I hurt people, I feel sad. I feel bad. Because sometimes it's not intentional. Why? Because I knew that those people may not have that grace to forgive quick. And it might be dangerous to them. But I always enjoy when people hurt me. And it's so funny. Why? Because God has taught me how to forgive very fast. And when people hurt me and I know I cry to God, God will answer me. I have discovered that through tears and pain, it's as if there's, my emotion is connected when I pray to God. And there's a connection. The reason why I'm bringing this scripture, this message, for us to make use of our tears. Praise the Lord. And the Lord will help us in Jesus' name. If therefore you feel today that no one sees your tears, be assured that God sees them. Tears brings healing when we are surrounded by pain and sorrow. Sometimes you are grieved and you cry. You feel relieved. You are sorrowful. You cry. You feel relief. You feel this comfort. You feel this peace. Another thing is that tears lubricate our eyes and help to wash away dust and other irritants. I remember sometime I was experiencing dryness of eye. I was looking for tears to come out from my eye. I did not see. I had to start thinking about bad experience so that I would just cry. I have to think of people that have offended me so that at least tears will come out from my eye. Sometimes I will use onions. I will cut onions, do the onions like this, so that tears will come. I was looking for tears just to lubricate my eyes. Praise God. So if tears can relieve us of sorrows and pain, if tears can lubricate our eyes and remove dust and other irritants, then what don't you think that this your tears is even more precious and important to God? Don't see that when you cry, you're a baby. Praise God. Like some men will say that I'm a man, I don't cry. But you cry inside. Praise God. Even if people don't see your tears, but inside you are what? You are crying. Quickly, I want us to look at something about tears. Number one, keep your eyes on God for healing through your tears. Keep your eyes on God for healing through your tears. Are you in need of healing, physically or emotionally? Has it brought pain and tears to your eyes? Look to God for healing in the name of Jesus. Because He is our healer, according to Exodus chapter 15, verse 26, God is our healer. If you look at the story of Anna in 1 Samuel chapter 1, verse 10, she was in bitterness of soul. And she prayed unto God, and she wept sore. Anna cried bitterly because she was emotionally distressed without the blessing of a child. To make the matter worse, arriver Peninnah consistently insulted her, adding salt to her wound. You can see that in 1 Samuel chapter 1, verse 6 to 7. To further worsen the matter, her pastor said she was what? Drunk. Even pastor could not understand the reason for the crime. Praise the Lord. But God showed up for Anna. Now, if you read that scripture very well, Anna do go to Shiloh to pray. Praise the Lord. Just like we do come to church to pray. But her mockers begin to mock her. And they began to provoke her. And she cried to God. And in the presence of Christ, she prayed a prayer she has never prayed before. And that caught God's attention. Let your eyes be on God. And let your tears bring about the healing. Praise the Lord. The Bible says in 1 Samuel chapter 1, 13. 1 Samuel chapter 2, verse 1, 3, and 5. The Bible says, and Anna prayed and said, my heart rejoices in the Lord. My horn is exalted in the Lord. My mouth is enlarged over my enemies because I rejoice in their salvation. Talk no more so exceedingly proudly. Let not arrogance come out of your mouth. For the Lord is God of knowledge. He has knowledge. He's taking note of the tears. Praise God. And by him, actions are weighed. I pity those who are mocking you because you are a nobody now, because God is going to make you a somebody. They that were full have hired out themselves for bread, and they that were hungry ceased, so that the barren had borne seven, and she that had many children is waxed feeble. And I decree into your life that blessed are you who weep now, for you will laugh in the name of Jesus. Blessed are you that weep now, for you shall laugh in the name of Jesus Christ. According to Isaiah chapter 60 verse 14, the sons also of them that afflicted thee shall come, bending unto thee. And all they that despise thee shall bow themselves down at the soles of thy feet. And they shall call thee the city of the Lord, the Zion of the Holy One of Israel. I decree unto you that the sons of them that have afflicted you, they shall come bending to you in the name of Jesus. And all they that despise you shall bow themselves down at the soles of your feet. And they shall call you the city of the Lord, the Zion of the Holy One of Israel, in the mighty name of Jesus. For you who is trusting God for the fruit of the womb, God shall make you a joyful mother of children, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Number two, keep your eyes on God when sowing in tears. You may be laboring in your career, in your business or ministry, just name it, without much physical success. You must have read the success stories of others, and you are wondering how success seems to have passed you by. God sees your tears that you sow faithfully. God will bring the harvest He has prepared for you at the appointed time, and He will reward your fruitfulness. He will reward your faithfulness with fruitfulness in the name of Jesus. Therefore, according to Psalms chapter 136 verse 5, I decree unto you, as you sow in tears, you shall reap in joy. As you go out weeping, carry seed to sow, you shall return with songs of joy. Your weeping in the night shall turn to joy in the morning. The Lord shall turn your mourning to dancing. The Lord shall turn your misery to ministry. For your trouble, the Lord shall give you double honor. In the mighty name of Jesus, be assured, your tears will be the seed for the rewards and the results God will bring to your life. Jeremiah chapter 31 verse 16 says, thus said the Lord, refrain their voice from weeping and their eyes from tears, for thy work shall be worth rewarded, said the Lord, and they shall come again from the land of the enemies. Therefore, let us fight victory through our tears. Let us do what? Fight victories through our tears. Let your tears draw God's attention. And the Lord will help us in the name of Jesus. There's a particular song I love so much. I watched in a movie and I brought this song. This song has always inspired me. It's a Manzaio film, The Secret, I think it's The Secret Place also. He said, though it seems that your prayers have been in vain, though your faith in the world would destroy, though your heart should ache till it breaks in two, then a soul in tears shall reap in joy. Then a soul in tears shall reap in joy, for God is on the throne. Though it seems that you pray till your heart will break, then a soul in tears shall reap in joy. And that shall be your testimony in the name of Jesus. To rise up in your feet and begin to appreciate God. Begin to pray. Begin to appreciate Him. Begin to appreciate Him. Thank Him. Thank Him. Because He's a good God. They that sow in tears shall reap in joy. They that go in forth weeping, bring precious seed, shall that blessing come back with their seed rejoicing. Every tears you have sown, the Lord will reward you. Begin to appreciate Him. they that sow in tears shall reap in joy. I shall reap in joy. Father, I thank you because I know every tear that I sow is not wasted. It goes to heaven in remembrance. Lord, I say thank you. Thank you for the tears of relief. You may not understand the reason, the mystery behind tears, but today you have opened the eyes of understanding. By this revelation, Lord, we shall receive, we shall receive, we shall receive answers to our prayer. Now that we understand that our tears draws your attention, now we pray with understanding, we cry with understanding, we share our tears with understanding in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Father, Lord, for in Jesus' mighty name we have